2023. As you see in the figure, we have three capacitors, C1 equal 12 nanofarad, C2 equal 4 nanofarad, and C3 equal 2 nanofarad are connected as below. Calculate the equivalent capacitance of the three capacitors. To calculate the equivalent capacitance, let's see which one is connected in series and which capacitors are connected in parallel. For the C1 and C2 are connected in series, so their equivalent capacitance B, 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2 power minus 1. And these two capacitors are connected in parallel with the third one, so it's going to be plus C3. We are done in just one step. So just we substitute by the numbers and we're going to get 1 over 12 nanofarad plus 1 over 4 nanofarad power minus 1 plus 2 nanofarad. So the result is going to be 5 nanofarad. And this is the equivalent capacitance of this circuit. For question B, what is the charge Q2? The charge on the capacitor C1 is Q1 equal 24 nanocoulomb. So nanofarad, nanocoulomb, sorry. So the charge here is 24. He's asking about the charge on the second capacitor. So you see that C1 and C2 are connected in series. C1 and C2 are connected in series. So what will be the charge on C1? The charge on C1 is going to be the charge on C2. Why? Because they are connected in series, so it's going to get, we're going to write, so 24 nano coulomb. We have done just one step. Question 3. What are the potential differences VA minus VB? This is VA minus VB. And the potential across the capacitor C1 and the potential difference VB minus VC across the capacitor C2. So as you know, the potential difference across the capacitor VA minus VC, VB, sorry, is equal to the charge of the capacitor Q1, which is equal to 24 nanocoulomb, divided by the capacitance, divided by C1. So we're gonna write 24 times 10 power negative 9 coulomb divided by C1, and C1 in the question he wrote, he said it's 12 nanofarad. 12 nano, that means 10 power minus 9. We can simplify, so we're gonna get 2 watt for the first one, okay? For the second one, VB minus VC. We will do the same thing. It's going to be Q2 divided by C2. The potential difference across the capacitor C2 is equal to the charge on the capacitor C2, which is equal to 24 nano coulomb divided by the capacitance C2. And C2 in the question, he said 4 nanofarad divided by 4 times 10 power negative 9. But that's all you're going to get, 6 volt. Question D, what is the potential difference delta V of the battery? You see that delta V of the battery is connected in parallel with the C3, and it's also connected in parallel with the combination of C1 and C2. So we can draw, we can draw our circuit as the following. This is delta V. And delta V is in parallel with C3, which is in turn connected parallel with the combination C1 and C2. So if we know delta V across the capacitor C1, delta V across the capacitor C2, this is VAB, and this is VC, VBC. So what we're gonna get, delta V equal VA minus VB plus VB plus VC and minus VC. Okay, so what we're gonna get, because they are connected parallel. So the result will be 2 plus 6 equals 8 volt. So this is the potential difference across the battery. Let's move to question E. What is the total energy stored in the system of the three capacitors? Good question. So as you know, the energy stored in the capacitor, U total, equal the half of C equivalent delta V squared. Okay, delta V across all the capacitors. So it's gonna we're gonna write C equivalent, how much we said? We said it's 5, so half of 5 nanofarad multiplied by delta V, which is 8 squared. So the result will be 1.6 times 10 power minus 7. 1.6 times 10 power minus 7. And of course, it's Joule. We have done. Last question of this problem. The dielectric of dielectric constant kappa equal 2 is inserted between the plates of the capacitor C3. So here we will fill the space between the two parallel plates of the capacitor C3 with a dielectric, where the dielectric constant is equal to. What is the new total energy stored in the system of the three capacitors? Here, to answer this question, U total is going to be the energy stored in C1 plus the energy stored in C2 plus the energy stored in C3. Okay, it's the sum. However, the energy stored in the third capacitor is going to be different to the other one, because here we inserted the dielectric. And in the same time, it equals 1 over 2 C equivalent prime multiplied by delta V squared. The question, what will be this C prime, C equivalent prime? C equivalent prime, it's going to get, it's going to be, one over C1 plus 1 over C2 power minus 1, because they are series as before, plus C3 prime now. Okay, C3 prime is what? Well, C3 prime is equal kappa, the dielectric constant, multiplied by C3. That's all. We are done. Just we substitute by the numbers, and we're going to get C equivalent prime to be 1 over, how much is C1? C1, 12, and C2, 4. 1 over 12 plus 1 over 4 power minus 1 plus 2 kappa multiplied by C3. C3, how much? 2. Multiplied by 2. That's all. This is C equivalent. C equivalent will be 7 nanofarad. 7 nanofarad. This is C prime equivalent after the dielectric. After inserting the dielectric on the capacitor C3. Okay, now let's come back to this equation. U equal U total equal the half of C equivalent. C equivalent we said is 7 nanofarad multiplied by delta V squared. Here the capacitors are still connected to the battery, so multiplied by 8 squared, the same potential difference as before. So it's going to be 2.24 multiplied by 10 power minus 7 joule. We are done with the problem. Thank you so much. See you in the problem 4.